Welcome to ABCP's Iqua Department. Here we deal with the Indian Child Welfare Act on a daily basis, and we're here to set the record straight. The Indian Child Welfare Act is alive and well, and it's the gold standard at which we hold the child welfare system accountable for.
Iqua was important in the 1970s, but it's no longer needed now. False. Iqua still provides much needed protections for Indian children and families. Statistics show that Indian children still face many of the same issues that they did in the 1970s.
Myth. Iqua only requires efforts to protect the children after they've been removed from the homes, not even on Wednesdays. The fact is that prevention and intervention is the way to help them stay.
Myth, ICWA is a race-based law. This is false. ICWA, like other federal Indian legislation, is based on the unique political status of tribes and Indian people, not race. This status, established by Congress, the Constitution, statutes, and treaties, has been affirmed and reaffirmed by U.S. Supreme Court decisions for 200 years.
Myth, ICWA funnels children into villages which are bad places to raise children. False. ICWA has no such requirements regarding where a child should be physically raised. Unfortunately, issues of child abuse and neglect is a nationwide problem and not specific to any community. Alaskan Native children thrive in their village. Alaskan Native culture keeps Alaskan Native children safe.
Myth. ICWA applies only to involuntary proceedings. False. ICWA was designated to also protect Indian children in voluntary proceedings, while some of the proceeding provisions ICWA do not apply in voluntary proceedings. Many important provisions still apply, including those provisions specifically to procedures for voluntary adoption and foster care placements.
The myth is ICWA ignores the best interests of Indian children. That's totally false. ICWA is designed to promote the best interests and unique needs of the Indian child. ICWA is not just considered good practice for Native children by expert and practitioners, but the principles and processes ICWA embodies were recently described by 18 national child welfare agencies as the gold standard for child welfare practice for all children.
Myth. ICWA applies to all children who identify as Native American. False. ICWA applies to children who are eligible for membership of a federally recognized Indian tribe or is eligible for membership of a federally recognized tribe and is the biological child of a member of a federally recognized Indian tribe.
Myth. ICWA favors Indian family members over non-Indian family members. False. Non-Indian family members have fundamental rights that are protected and dovetail with ICWA, so that is not the case.